Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I am going to finally do a fill-in on my little holiday winter Tiffany nails. First of all, pat myself on the back because I did this set November, like, 12th, I think? And they're still on. I'm not missing any stones. Just a little bit of lifting, which I'm going to get up on, taking the polish off and prepping my nail for the new set. But this is the first set that I've had, that I have done myself, that has lasted this long. I'm so proud of myself. So basically, all I'm doing now is getting the polish off, and I am going to try to file down the snowflake decals. And yes, I know there's dust everywhere. Don't even get me started. My dust collector from AliExpress. Don't do it, sis. Don't get that dust collector from AliExpress. I don't care how cheap it is. Don't do it. Use my code down below and buy one from the cart. I've got one on the way. Just use my code down below and get you one from the cart. Don't get that dust collector from AliExpress. I've gotten more than one, and let's just say they all spark when I plug them in. I don't like that. If you're cool with that, that's fine, but I don't do sparks, and anything that makes me think that, you know, a fire may start in my home. So I had to use the comb bit to get the stone little bow tie or a little bow off of my nail, so I just kind of used that and dug around it and it popped off, if you can see. And it's intact, so I do keep them when I do them on myself. I keep my stones that I take off and my little decorations, I keep them in a little baggie for, you know, my personal use, not to use on anybody else or anything like that. So we're just gonna go through here and finish getting the rest of this polish off, try to file some of these decals out if we can, and then we'll move on to doing the prep for the fill. Okay, now that we've got all that taken care of, I've got it all off, I'm gonna push my cuticles back, and then after I get them all pushed back, I'm gonna use the opposite end and scrape up the crusties, and then I'm gonna go in with my cuticle clean bit and my cuticle bit that I got from Red Iguana in my mystery box, and I am going to clean up my cuticles and get all those crusties. Like I said, these nails have been on for over a month at this point. And I got a lot of crusty and cuticle things going on, so we're gonna go ahead and get that up so we can start the fill. now that we've got that all together, I am going to prep, prime, and base coat my nails, and then we are going to finally be ready to do my first ever fill. So I'm interested to see how this turns out. So this first layer is just going to be kind of like getting to the cuticle and kind of brushing it out kind of thin, because I am going to try to encapsulate some of this beautiful Daily Charm glitter that I got in my nail boxy. And I failed to mention, pretty much everything that I'm using came out of nail boxy except for the poly gel. That is McCart, of course, because they have the clear, so the clear. But the glitter came from my January nail boxy. The Swarovskis came for my January and another month nail boxy. And the charm that I'm gonna use came from Daily Charm and my January nail boxy. And the nail polish and the top coat that I'm going to use came in my January nail boxy. If you would like to see the unboxing for that, it is on my IGTV, and I will leave the link down below, because you know I do unboxings on IGTV now. And I do the actual design for the nail boxy, or whatever unboxing I did, will be on my YouTube channel following that. You guys, look at this glitter. It's so sparkly and pretty. Oh, I was just, I know it seems like I'm taking forever to do this nail, but because I keep getting like amazed at the glitter, and I keep playing with it and rearranging it, and basically also trying to cover up that snowflake, which I didn't even have to do all that, because in the end, when I cleaned up the underside of the nail, it did file the rest of the snowflake away, so you can't even see it anyway. But you guys, the glitter is just beautiful. If you're not sure what nail boxy is, basically it is a nail subscription box that you can get each month. It's $29.99, and it features usually like 5 to 10 full-size products each month. This month was a collaboration with, well, not a collaboration, they featured Daily Charm. There were some red iguana things in there too. There were Swarovski, and then there was Libra's Nails special edition nail polish. Like I said, if you want to see the unboxing, go on over to my IGTV, because it was a beautiful box and it had a lot of good stuff in it. So yes, I'm just gonna basically put this glitter how I want it, then encapsulate it, then go on to continue the fill. Thank you. wipe the tacky layer off, which is what I'm doing now, and you can't really see. And then I'm going to go in with my comb bit and kind of clean up the undersides, clean up the sides, clean up anything that I need to clean up. Then I'm going to use my safety bit to go around the cuticles, cut down some of the bulk on the encapsulated nail, and just to make sure my cuticles are flush and that the bulk from, you know, my previous exes is a fill. Make sure I got all of that down if I didn't get it all from the filing I did before. And as you can see, all the teeth so flaky cows did not come out. So like I said, we're just gonna go over that. So basically I'm gonna file, shape, and buff, and then we are gonna get to the design. Okay, so I decided to go with the Annalisa color from the Libra's Nails Special Edition Nail Boxing Polishes. This color is Annalisa, the other color is April, and they're both named after the owners of Nail Boxy. As of right now, the only way you can get these polishes is if you were subscribed to Nail Boxy in December, or now that it is January, it should be moved over to the pass boxes section, so you could actually just pay $29.99 and get the pass box and get these polishes and everything else that came in the box. And also for pass boxes, you can use Afterpay. Don't get it twisted, they don't pay me for any type of advertising. They don't pay me for jack. I don't work for them. I just really love subscriptions, and I really love how I can try out a bunch of different nail products and not have to pay a whole bunch of money and come out of my pocket. Especially with these being good quality products, not cheap products. So I have put on 2 coats of the polish, and now I'm going to use my Dulce Nail Sprinkles gem glue, which are gem gel, however it is. It came in a Nail Boxy as well. The Nail Boxy that one came in was like a full Dulce Sprinkles Nail Boxy. It came with amazing stuff, glitter, all this beautiful amazing stuff. So I'm gonna use that. And then I'm going to put a dollop of poly gel, as you can see, over it. And that is what I use to put the charm on. Then I'm going to take my... Oh, actually, I haven't done that yet. So basically what I'm going to do is to put the charm on. I'm going to put the gem glue on my nail. And then I'm going to put a dollop of poly gel over it. Then I'm going to stick the charm in and flatten out the poly gel around it to make it kind of flush, but also to make sure that the charm is secured and stays on my nails, because you guys know I do not like things coming off my nails. I do pretty good with my keeping my stones on and things like that, but this being a little bit bigger and a little bit chunkier, I decided to just go ahead and use the gem glue plus a little dollop of poly gel just to make sure that it stayed and to make sure that it was in all the crevices and everything like that. And then later I will go around it with some top coat to seal that around. And basically my method for applying stones, which is what I'm gonna do with the Swarovskis once I'm done with this, I put down the glue, then I put a little bit of top coat over it, then I stick the gems in, then I cure it, then I go back and use the top coat I want to use for my finish, which is going to be the Libra's Nail Glossy top coat. I'm going to use that and make it super, super glossy. You guys watch, I promise you, this set is going to be so cute. Now that I've got the stones cured, I'm going to use the glossy finish top coat. And guys, look at how beautiful that is. Look at the sparkle. Oh my gosh. This may be my new favorite top coat. I kid you not. And let's see how it does on the glitter. It is so pretty. You guys, this set, it ended up coming out beautiful. That's a little tip about clear nails. To help, you know, bring out the clearness and to make sure it's not too cloudy, go under the bottom with a little bit of top coat before you cure, and it'll make it super, super clear. But you guys, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I am going to let you get into the rest of this video so you can see the nails without my voice all in the background. And I will see you guys in the next one.